Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Hey, Caitie, happy birthday. I don't know how old you turned today, but, no, because nobody was saying it online when they were tweeting you and all that, but you know, it's your birthday, and so here's a video for you, like your birthday special, like I did Alexis yesterday. Here's your birthday song, and so before I get into it, I'm going to say a few things, but I'm just going to warn you that the song has a little cussing in it, and has a lot of humor. I think in the second chorus, there's two choruses in it. You're gonna be, when I sing that part, you're gonna be like, damn you, Mark, why the hell did you have to put that in the song? You'll see what it is. You're gonna get a kick out of it. And show this to all the girls, too. Show this to all the girls, too. Now that way they can see it. And hear the lyrics. Anyway, our friendship started last summer at Home Days, June 19th of last year at Middleburg Home Days, where, hold on. Sorry about that. Anyway, so Middleburg Home Days, where I was just walking along, minding my own business, then all of a sudden, I got into a huge crowd with you, Alexis, Emma, Olivia, Gina, Emily, Lexi Hedrick, Ari Hedrick, Jordan Caracella, some friends I knew from before, and some new friends like you, Alexis, and all the other girls who you hang out with all the time. One of my favorite memories together with you was when you and Alexis watched one of my UNA broadcasts from her account. I gave you a shout out and danced to Ricky Martin for you. And another fondest memory, another great memory was the Home Days events where you and the girls always tickled me all the time. Because Alexis was the first to know I was tickled. She was the first out of all of you to tickle me. And she's been doing it since then. So have you a little bit. But she does it more than you. So yeah, also, I'm playing this game for you, except it's not Wheel of Fortune, it's Sister Show Jeopardy with Alex Trebek. Yeah, you're not getting a story like Alexis did, but hey, at least a video game, a birthday song, and a video is better than nothing, right? So, yeah. Here's your birthday song, without further ado. Happy birthday to you, Caitlin O'Donnell. Hope you have bam bam a wonderful day, and all your wishes come true. First meeting bam bam came last summer at Middleburg Home Days, where we danced to Ricky Martin, bam bam, and her, and the girls tickled me. And said, hey, Mark is Caitlin, and I got so pissed with them.
For scaring me, for no reason. I was so pissed.
Let me turn off that light, we don't need it. It's our birthday, let's celebrate together as a family. Can't wait to add new memories in 2K50 with her and all the girls. Yeah. just waiting for my cue. Oh, here it comes. I almost started too soon. Sorry about that. Hey, she got to meet my mom, along with all the other girls, when they were all tickling me. But a Ferris wheel, at the end of the night. Yeah! Happy birthday to you. Bam bam, Caitlin O'Donnell. Oh, that is the best birthday ever. And your birthday dinner at the Garden with the girls was amazing.
On October 22nd, I heard news from Twitter that a girl peed on her while school was in session. The girl massive beat down for doing that shit right on her. I wish I knew right away that happened so I could talk about the girl who did it. Caitlin O'Donnell! Caitlin O'Donnell! Caitlin O'Donnell! Caitlin O'Donnell! Oh, your information is great today and let you have fun with your friends.
Caitlin O'Donnell! There you go. I messed up on the word celebration, but that's okay. At least I didn't mess up more than once. But anyway, that's the humor right there, the second chorus. You're probably going to be like, oh, damn it. Why the hell did they have to put that incident in the song? Well, I just wanted to make it funny. That's all. But anyway, before I get to the video game, I want to let you know that pretty soon I'm not going to be living by you anymore. I'm going to be moving somewhere else, and I'm not going to just give it out here on YouTube, so I don't want no creeps knowing where I live. So, if you follow me on Twitter, so that way I can message you my new address, which I will definitely not be giving on here. And so this way, you can give it to the rest of the girls, and then you can all come visit me if you want. Even though I don't live close by you anymore, I'll still be friends with you. So anyway, that was your birthday song. Here's the video game I'm going to play for you for your birthday. Okay, Caitlin, here you go. This is the PS1 version of Jeopardy, the first edition for the PS1. Came out long before you were born.
Okay, set the game up exactly the way you like.
So we'll leave that those alone. We're gonna make everything easy for you. Since you're getting credited and not me. Because of the glare, you can't see that. It's spelling tolerance, loose, and strict, and the skill level, easy, hard. I put it to loose and strict for you, just in case you can't see that. It's the damn glare. Answer adaptive AI, yes. Answer completion, yes. Interlace, yes. Oh, yeah, turn that volume high.
So what are you gonna do?
Normal game, Johnny.
Okay, so how many people are out there?
One.
Man against machines, alright.
Alright, it's actually girl against the machine.
Player one, what's your name?
Alright, here we go. I'm going to try to draw your name. Okay, I turn after the analog stick off to do this. So this is going to be hard. I can't press the X button or so it's just going to mark it done. No, it's not going to work. This is going to be hard. I was never good at this as a kid. So I might be here for a little bit. Hang on, let me see if I can make a C. I'm gonna write Caitie, just if I can do this right. Oh my god. Oh, I got the clear button. Okay, let's try it again. Okay, slowly. Oh my god, I have to use the analog stick. I mean, not the analog stick, the directional button. Hang on. This is gonna be a while. I'll try to make it a small. Oh, come on. Yeah, I'm trying to write your name. I'm going to write Caitie instead of Caitlin just to make it better. Whoops. Don't want that. Okay, the A is too long. Yeah, so prepare to laugh a lot in this video because of the difficulty to write with this damn thing. The X button is to when I hit the X button, that means we're gonna go play the game. Hang on, that A looks like a Q. I'm gonna actually make it a capital A. I was trying to make a lowercase A and I sucked. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. Capital A. I'll be so pissed if I hit the X button by accident. Okay, I almost got it. Whoops. Okay, come on, there you go. Almost there. Don't fail me now. I don't think something I would say when I'm playing a racing game and I'm close to winning the race and it's a close finish, but this is just for writing your name. All right, one more, the E. That's the door opening in the background. Just ignore that, Caitie. It's my mom walking out the door. Looks good. All right, let's go. Looks very, very good. Hopefully we can become Jeopardy champion. Here's Johnny!
Welcome to another game of Jeopardy.
Thank you, Alex. It's been a while since I've played this game. Jeopardy. Alright, here we go. Ready, Caitie? Hopefully I can win this. You can become Jeopardy champion. Sorry about the glare in the background. This happens a lot when it's light outside.
We've got some really interesting first round categories for you.
Alright.
Around the world.
Turn it up a little bit.
Just desserts. Pen names. Cathedrals and...
Oh, I remember nailing that category as a kid.
Rulers. Films of the 90s.
Okay, player one. Start us off.
Hi, Caitie, you get to start. What are we going to start? Cathedrals and churches for 100, please.
Victor Hugo described it as a vast...
Oh, I know this.
Quasimodo would agree.
Player one.
What is Notre Dame? I gotta check if I remember the controls.
That's correct.
Yes!
Alright, pick again.
Not shit has changed with this game, when I was playing it.
James Renwick designed this Fifth Avenue Cathedral in the Gothic Revival style.
I know this one too.
Player one.
What is the St. Patrick's Cathedral? I'm trying to remember the controls because I haven't played this game in a while. I'm trying to make sure I don't hit triangle by accident. Yeah!
You're building up a big lead.
Damn right she is, because she's the fucking birthday girl, Alex. 300.
The Basilica of the Holy Blood in Bruges in this country...
Oh, I know this one, too.
...believed to be drops of Christ's blood.
What is Belgium?
That's correct.
Yes!
All right, pick again.
400.
This English city's modern cathedral, built in 1962, stands next to the bombed-out ruins of the old one.
I don't remember this one.
Where?
Oh, damn. No, that's not it.
Regrettably, no.
Nope.
There's a lot of game left, so hang in there.
Yeah.
Here is the correct
Coventry. Oh, my God. It's been a while since I've given some of the answers I remember, some of the answers
right,
I don't. All right, let's finish out the category. 500.
The cathedral of this northern Italian city looks quite fashionable with its 100.
Shit, I don't remember this one either.
Player two?
Milano?
Right,
or Milano, however the hell you pronounce it.
You're not far back now.
No, he's not.
Okay, player two.
Let's see if we can get some more. Just desserts for 100 he's picking.
This fruit dessert is known as Betty for short.
What is strawberry? I'm just gonna guess. Strawberry shortcake. Nope.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect.
Damn. Apple Brown Betty. I should have known that from the Napa Know How commercial.
Player two, you choose.
Lost $100 because of that. Getting out of there. Oh, great. That was a big mistake on my part. He's betting it all. So give him a $100 lead if he's correct.
The name of these South American mountains may be derived from Anti, a Quechuan word for east.
Don't know. Out of the Andrews?
Wrong.
Yeah! I caught a break. The Andes! Okay, he got the names mixed up.
All right,
rulers, we're not going to get this.
Many say this country's ruler, Zhu Xi, gave a death...
Oh, Japan, I know this.
...you, the emperor, killed.
Player one?
Japan, what is Japan?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Damn. China. I got it mixed up.
All right, pick again.
Still in the lead. Not by much, though.
In 1994, Silent Fall introduced this teenage beauty who became a star in Stealing Beauty.
I have no idea. Liv Tyler?
Yes.
Ooh.
All right, pick
He's again. Gonna stay there.
Daniel Day-Lewis starred in the 1996 movie adaptation of this Arthur Miller play.
Don't have a clue. The Crucible. Crucible, however the hell I pronounce it.
All right, pick again.
Gina Davis and Susan Sarandon take the ultimate road trip and meet Brad Pitt in this 1991 movie.
I was not born yet, so I have no clue. Thelma and Louise. Can we just get an easy one in this damn category?
This actress tried to come between Dermot Mulroney and Cameron Diaz in 1997's My Best Friend's Wedding.
Never seen that movie, so I have no idea.
Player three.
Julia Roberts.
To be sure.
Should have guessed that. Oh, well. Pen names.
This Lolita author wrote 9 Russian novels under the name V. Sirin.
Player three. Right, you are.
I don't know shit about pen names, so I'm not going to get any of them.
All right, pick again.
It's a really low-scoring game so far.
While a student, this Andromeda Strain author used the pen names John Lang and Jeffrey Hudson.
Here is the correct response.
Damn.
All right, pick again.
William Sidney Porter wrote The Ransom of Red Chief under this pen name.
I don't know nothing about this shit. Who is Bret Hart?
That's wrong.
Nope.
Anybody?
Uh-uh. Here's Henry.
All right, pick again.
His early work appears in an obscure Armenian language publication under the name Sirak Gorian.
Don't know.
Player two? That's correct.
What was the answer?
Player two?
Still in the lead by only 200. He's going back to films on 90s for 500.
Bette Midler, Diane Keaton, and Goldie Hawn were a trio of spurned spouses in this 1996 movie.
Don't know.
Player two?
Parenthood.
Ooh,
nope! This has been a rough-ass round. First Wife's Club.
To be sure.
Oh.
Your choice, player three.
Now player three is in the lead.
This country's King Harold III was the half-brother of St. Olaf.
Player three.
No way. They would never have guessed that.
You are correct. All right, pick again.
In 1993, King Hussein celebrated his 40th anniversary as ruler of this country.
I think I might know this one. Let me think. What is Iran?
Oh, I'm so
damn!
Player two? Yes. Player two, what'll it be?
Down to $100.
This country's King Alfonso II was known as Alfonso O Gordo, which means Alfonso the Fat.
Player one?
I'm gonna guess Spain. I don't know. I was sitting around guessing that country is.
That's wrong.
Damn it! We're falling apart here, Caitie. Portugal. Minus 300. We after all that good start we had.
The short, medium, or long grain type of this may be used to make pudding.
Rice.
Player two, you choose.
This has not been a good game so far.
It's the family name of Peter the Great and Alexander the First.
Player two?
Romanov.
Yes. All right, pick again.
Hopefully we can get out of the hole here. Not in this category, we won't.
He wrote The Big Needle as Simon Miles and Eye of the Needle as himself.
Player two?
Ken Follett.
That's correct.
All right, pick again.
Around the world.
Women of India often drape the end of this wrapped garment over their heads.
I'm trying to think of the name of it. I know what it is, but I just don't...
Here is the correct response.
That was not what I was thinking.
All right, pick again.
This pie with a sheer fabric in its name contains beaten egg whites and or gelatin.
Chiffon pie.
All right, pick again.
Almost all Bedouins in the Middle East speak this language.
Arabic. Damn.
All right,
this has been really low scoring.
In names of desserts, this woman's name may follow chocolate or precede rousse.
Chocolate Charlotte. Damn.
All right, pick again.
This grain is Laos' chief agricultural product.
Rice again? Second time it's been a correct response.
Pick again.
Hope we can get one more clue.
Black Forest cake is made with kirsch, a liquor made from this fruit.
Player three.
Cherries.
To be sure. And to finish...
If we don't get this one, you're going first in Double Jeopardy, Caitie.
Queen's University, one of the two universities in Northern Ireland, is in this capital city.
Anybody?
No. Belfast.
Here's the correct response.
So let's take a look at the scores of the Jeopardy round.
Well, that brings us to the end of the first round.
Let's look at the total score.
So player 3 is in the lead, 1,300. Player 2 is in the end, second with 1,000. You're in third place with negative 300. Excuse me. That means you'll be picking first in Double Jeopardy, Caitie.
All right, it's time for Double Jeopardy.
Here we go. Double Jeopardy! This is a lot tougher round with two daily doubles, including a video daily double. My camera's low on battery, so hopefully I can get through this, done with this in time.
Let's get to the categories for Double Jeopardy.
Hopefully we can get some easy categories.
Seas.
Yes.
Saints. Soap opera history.
Oh, I got this.
Celebrities middle.
There's a lot of good ones here.
Disneyland.
Disneyland.
Gardening. Player one, you get us going.
All right. Where should we go? Celebrities middle names for 200, please.
Middle name shared by Jamie Curtis.
Oh, I know this one. What is Lee?
Player one. Correct.
Yes!
All right, pick again.
Desiree was the middle name of this star who married a man named Desi.
Player two?
Lucille Ball.
That's it, exactly.
I used to know that, but I couldn't remember. He's staying there.
Bridget Fonda's middle name. It's her famous aunt's first name.
Player one?
Jane. Almost forgot that one.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's your turn.
Out of the hole, thank God. 800. Celebrities' middle names.
It's a gem of a middle name.
I know this.
Lou Phillips.
What is Diamond?
Player one.
Whoops. Not Diablo. We're not playing Need for Speed.
Correct.
Yes!
Alright, pick again.
We're getting there. This last one's going to be easy. I had this category many times.
It's the middle name of Sarah Parker, who went on a honeymoon in Vegas.
What is Jessica? And I have a friend named Jessica, too. I have a lot of friends named Jessica.
That's correct.
Yes! You're in the lead now.
Right, pick again.
This is getting good. Disneyland for 200.
Of the Haunted Mansion, Jungle Cruise, or Swiss Family Treehouse. The one that's been at Disneyland since opening day.
I think I might remember this. What is Swiss Family Treehouse? Excuse me. Damn it! The Jungle Cruise.
Alright, pick again.
Simba was the main attraction.
You were, everybody would know this.
Inspired by this film.
What is the Lion King? As I call it, the Saddam Hussein movie or the Birdie Boiler movie?
You are correct.
Almost ran out of time there.
All right, pick again.
On Disneyland's 40th birthday, July 17, 1995, Randy Travis led a sing-along from the top of this alpine mountain.
Don't even remember what it was.
Three.
The Matterhorn. Oh, now I know.
Yeah.
Now I remember.
Player three, what'll it be?
Gives me a free hundred picking.
A time capsule buried at this castle in 1995 will be opened on Disneyland's 80th anniversary in 2035.
That's a long way from now. Sleeping Beauty's castle.
That's right.
Damn.
All right, pick again.
The exciting ride named for this character is a perilous journey through the Temple of the Forbidden Eye.
Anyone?
Indiana Here's Jones.
All right, pick again.
C is for 200.
Two island nations lie within this sea, Cyprus and Malta.
What is the Mediterranean Sea? Camera's getting low on battery. I hope we can make it.
This sea was named for a warlike tribe of Indians that inhabited the Lesser Antilles.
Caribbean Sea or Caribbean Sea, I really want to say it.
What'll it be, player one?
C is for 600.
The Scheldt River flows through Antwerp before emptying into this sea.
I think it's the Red Sea, I think. Not the Replacements. I gotta hurry the hell up.
I'm sorry.
Damn it! The North Sea. Damn!
What'll it be, player one?
Although discovered by Semyon Desnev in 1648, this arm of the North Pacific was named for another man.
Anybody?
No. The Bering Sea.
Player one?
The world's largest inland body of water, its surface lies about 90 feet below sea level.
Player one, what'll it be?
I'm actually going to stop right here. I'm going to charge my battery. Be right back. Welcome back. Sorry about that long-ass delay. Caitie, it looked like took like a fucking hour or two because my battery's taking forever to charge. But I'm back and I'm ready to continue this birthday special for you. Let's resume the game. Stands for 200.
No actual details are known about the life of this patron saint of England.
Oh my god, I don't remember this one.
Player three.
St. Patrick.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I was thinking that, but good thing I didn't say it. St. George. I'm so glad I didn't say St. Patrick.
Okay, contestant one.
If I continue, let me fix the camera. Let me move it back a little bit. Sorry about this. There we go. Yeah, the glare is bigger now. Sorry about that. Alright, see it stands for 100.
Saint Erasmus, the patron saint of sailors, gets all fired up under this other name.
Wait, what was the answer? Saint Elmo?
Yes, indeed.
Damn.
Player three, it's your turn.
He's known for asking Jesus, Vadis Domine? And being crucified upside down.
Anybody?
No! St. Peter.
Contestant three, it's your turn.
Excuse me.
St. Basil the Blessed was an advisor to the Tsar in this city. A church there is named for him.
Player two?
Moscow.
Yes.
Damn.
All right, contestant two.
Hold on, let me see if I can get rid of this damn glare. Oh my god. There's nothing I can do about it. The sun just came out. Looks like we're going to have to live with it. Can't believe that fucking glare. Alright, let's continue the game.
Hype perpetuals like the American Beauty were the main type of these American gardens from 1840 to 1880. This king gave his powerful advisor Thomas Cromwell earldom in April 1540, but had him beheaded in July.
The game's glitching up again, like Wheel of Fortune yesterday. Sorry about that. Roses.
Player two?
In the name of St. Gregory...
Oh, I know this one!
Thaumaturgus means wonder worker in this language.
What is Greek?
Player one?
Finally, we're getting something, Caitie. We're getting something.
You are correct.
Yes!
It's your turn, player one.
You can't see the scores because of the glare. Hold on. 3,100, 2,200, you earned the leader at 3,100. Player 3 is in second place, 2,900. Player 2 is in third place, 2,200. Still a tight game. We got soap proper history and gardening. I'll just go to gardening, I guess, 400.
Answer?
Oh, shit. I'm only going to risk a little bit. I'm only going to risk up to, what should I risk? Only gonna risk 300.
The sphagnum, or peat type of this plant, has been used as a bedding and packing material.
Player one.
Good thing I didn't go all in because I have no clue. I'm just gonna guess cactus.
No. Too bad.
Damn.
Here is the correct response.
I never would have guessed that.
All right, pick again.
Let me see if I can get. Hold on. Yeah, so yeah, you can't see the scores. I'm a second place. Gardening for 600.
The oscillating type of this irrigation device sprays back and forth in a rectangular pattern.
Spray.
Here is the correct response.
Oh, I should have guessed that. I should have guessed that.
All right, pick again.
Yeah, so I apologize for to you, Kate, to everyone in advance, and Caitie herself. This glare got worse and worse as the day went on because the sun came out. So I think you can't see the TV, right? We just got to live with it. Gardening for 800.
Scarification is a technique where hard-shelled ones of these are scratched to help them sprout.
Seeds. Damn.
All right, pick again.
1,000.
Compared to a tree, this type plant produces its branches near, at, or below the soil surface.
No idea. Shrub. We have one category left.
All right.
And that video daily double is in there somewhere. Soul proper history. Yeah, 200.
Art. Based his 60s Gothfires on The House, a year play story he wrote in 1957. On March 9, 1995, this Chicago Bulls star played in first game after 1.5 years of time. The USA's largest national monument, this Mist Fjords, consists...
Sorry that the game glitching up again.
Long water. He let him strike this after...
It didn't do that all in the Jeopardy round.
...of an 1847 declaration of independence. The cap... is a site made dance from this country. Well, the Kai is a Hindu drama.
I think it's Wadsworth, Dracula.
America's oldest public art museum, located in the capital. His Guernica,
come on, game.
Was once exhibited at the Prado.
I'm not going to answer until Johnny shuts up. Thank you.
1633, brought forth the quiz.
Good guess, but no.
Damn. I guess Dracula, that was not right. Dark Shadows.
Alright, pick again.
It's a tight match.
The answer is...
Oh, God!
Player one, please make it.
What are we gonna do this time? 200 only.
Once Snapper on The Young and the Restless, he was a lifeguard on Baywatch.
Take a look at your monitor.
Let's see. I have no idea who that is.
Player one? Oh, I'm sorry.
I don't know.
Here is the
David Hasselhoff.
Alright, pick again.
Yeah, I'm making these little bets, so I won't risk losing a lot of money. 600.
When this daytime soap debuted in 1970, it featured three families. The Martins, Tylers, and Canes.
I think it's Days of Our Lives.
Anyone?
All My Children. Good thing I didn't try it.
Pick again.
Alright, 800.
This show about an Irish family and their tavern ended January 13th, 1989 with the cast singing Danny Boy.
Anybody?
I didn't tell, I wouldn't have guessed that.
And to finish the
board, time to finish last clue.
The title of this 1960s primetime series, The Hometown Harrisons and the McKenzies.
Nobody.
Here's the...
Okay, Caitie, it's time for final. This is really important.
That's the end of Double
Jeopardy. Late type match.
Let's take a look at the board.
Player 3's and lead 2,900. You're in second place 2,400, and player 2's in third place 2,200. It's a very tight match. Alright. This is really important. Hope we get an easy category.
Let's see what our category is for Final Jeopardy.
It is.
The Old Testament. Two, you made your keys. Black one, please your wig.
I'm only risking 200.
Three, we have triple. The end.
Yeah. The Feast of Passover much mentioned in this book. I could have gone all in on that. I know this one. Nope, not Genesis.
What's it going to cost you?
1,400.
Yeah, you'll get them next time.
Oh boy, I don't know. What a
player one. Let's take a look at your quick. Sorry, that's incorrect.
No, it's not the Bible either.
Let's see how much it cost you.
Only 200.
Sometimes you get a tough one.
Yeah, you do. It's all with the player three now.
Your question, player three.
Oh, yeah! How much did he cost? If he missed a lot, all of them... Ooh! Look at that, Caitie! Oh, Exodus! Insufficient space. I don't care. We're not going to save. Happy birthday, Caitie! Happy birthday! You won!
Congratulations, player one.
Yeah!
Jeopardy champion.
Aha!
See you next time for another game of Jeopardy.
Bye, Alex, and happy birthday to Caitie O'Donnell. You did it, Caitie. You are the fucking Jeopardy champion. All right. Well, there you have it, Caitie. You are the Jeopardy champion. It was not a big win, but hey, at least you won. That's all that matters. So I hope that's the best birthday gift you can ever receive this year, especially from me. A really good guy like me, who's there always there for his friends, especially ones who are female like you. So I look forward to home days this year, later this year, even though the postseason run, like I said. So I won't give it out here on here, you because they'll come and talk with me. I'll follow me on Twitter and I'll message you my address, my new address, where I'm moving to. And then just pass on the other girls whenever you all have them, just feel free to come by and visit me or anytime you want after I'm done living you by your own. And don't I wanna talk about the game, whatever I just played. I was on a roll on some clues, like I just stormed through that celebrity middle names category. I knew every answer because I remember from playing this game as a kid. So and I played it smart on those two daily doubles and the final Jeopardy. I had no clue to either question. No clue on the two daily doubles and no clue on the final Jeopardy question. No clue whatsoever. That's why I played it safe. So better safe than sorry, just like Alexis has said to me on Twitter. But I've almost before. Better safe than sorry. So had I risked a lot of money and then screwed it up, it would have cost me the victory. You see, if Alexis didn't win on Wheel of Fortune yesterday, you won on Jeopardy today. Hey, this is like, hopefully this will make up for not winning on Alexis' birthday yesterday on Wheel of Fortune, that you won on Jeopardy. And as you saw, I wrote your name very, very nice. So yeah, I hope, and also, one more thing before I go to the sign-off, I hope to see you guys, you and the rest of the girls really soon. That way I can give Alexis her story and her song, and I can give you your song too. Yeah, it's really funny too. I hope you show the girls, the rest of the girls, the video. After I tweet it to you, and if you guys tag you. That's not where they can hear the song, and why it's in the second chorus. They're probably gonna crack up laughing. But anyway, that was a great Jeopardy game. Happy birthday, Caitie. I hope that's a birthday special, aka a birthday video I made for you. I hope God bless you with many more birthdays to come in the future, and that you turn to a nice, bright young lady when you graduate 2019. Happy birthday. Love you.